Babies, how are you? How are you? How are you? My name is Siren Ray. You're watching Siren Ray Tarot. And today I'm coming back with another pick a card reading. And today's pick a card reading is going to be what makes you lit. What makes you lit? So we're going to take a look what makes you lit. I am so ready to read. I just worked out. I just worked out, guys. And after this, I'm going to go take me a shower. While it's uploads, I'm going to go take me a shower. Then I'm going to go get me some dick. And then I'm going to come home and lay down. Well, I'm going to come home and get back in the shower and then come home and lay down. Oh, so far. I went through like a little mini depression for a couple days. I was like overly tired. But I feel like that's how I get, I feel like that's how I get downloads, like in my sleep. Let's pile number two. Okay, they just want me to use the four decks. How interesting. I feel like that's how I get downloads and shit like that. Like when I'm, when I sleep a lot, because it'd be so random. Like, I have energy, like right now I have energy, but like for the past couple days I was so fucking tired. Like, my body was tired, my mind was tired, everything was tired. But today I feel energized. I want to work out. I can't wait till this weekend so I can go to the riverfront and work out and stuff like that. Like, I don't know, I'm really like, you know, up for it now. Crazy. Before I was like really like tired. That's crazy. It is crazy. I don't know, I just think it's so crazy. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's how I get downloads, I guess, because I was just so tired and depressed, but now I'm like up and I got energy and I want to do stuff. So that's what I'm going to be doing. So I'm gonna give you a couple minutes to choose. Let me get some water. Let me drink some water. I didn't drink enough water. This weekend I'll probably go to the park. But I will go to the park to shoot some content this weekend. So I'm really looking forward to doing that. I think about getting a bike. I'm gonna get a bike. Okay, guys, I'm about to get started. And I'm also thinking about getting a cat. Like, I've been wanting a cat for like so long, but I just haven't gotten one because my apartment is not, for me, I feel like it's not big enough for a cat. But I've been wanting a cat for so long. So I think I might just go ahead and get a cat. might just go ahead and get a cat this weekend as well. Okay, I don't know where I'm gonna place litter box at though. That's the thing. But I'm gonna figure it out. I'm gonna look at some litter box ideas. What makes pile number one lit? 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 What makes pile number one? I'm gonna do. Well, what advice do you have for pile number one? No, I get one of these. Okay, babies, let's see what we got here. So, our first card out is perspective. So what makes you lit is your ability to help others see a different perspective. So it's like, okay, like for example, maybe someone doesn't like carrots, right? And they're thinking about how carrots are like chalky and how they don't like the color orange and all this stuff, right? But you're the type of person, spirit, you're the type of person, baby, that you'll be like, okay, I understand that you don't like carrots, and yeah, they might, the raw carrots might taste like chalk or whatever, and you might not like the color orange, but what if you put your carrots in a smoothie and added like honey and stuff like that, so that way you like the taste, and maybe some organic food dye to change the color, because you need to eat carrots because it helps with your eyesight and is very healthy and stuff like that. You get what I'm saying? So it's like you help people to see stuff from a different perspective. What I get from that is also you're a very charming person. So that's what makes you lit, as you're a very charming person. People might take you with them when they need to close a deal on something. Like when they're gonna go buy something, like maybe a house or a car or something that they wanna get a deal on. You're a very good talker. You're very, 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 very good with your words, very good at convincing people to get the things you want. You're very charming. And what you be saying makes sense. So it's like to an average person that's maybe not as much of a charmer as you are, what you're saying is makes sense. Like you can literally convince somebody of anything just because like the way that you talk, your tone of voice, and like the way that you take what they said in consideration, but still getting your point across. Just like I had just said, like you acknowledge when I just gave you my example before I even gave you what to do or the alternative to that, I acknowledge that you didn't like carrots in the first place. That's something you would do. So people really feel like you listen to them. People really feel like you listen to them and you take what they have to say in consideration, and you work with them, and you're very flexible and but not in a pushover type way, but in a way of like kind of validating how they feel and stuff like that. Stop with somebody whispering in my motherfucking ear again, bro. Like this is what I be saying. I be trying to read, and like niggas be trying. Like I feel like, hold on, I'm so sorry, Kyle number one. I feel like motherfuckers be wanting me to be a medium, and I'm not a medium. Like, well, I don't know if I'm a medium. I don't know if I could be one, but like that's not something I want to do. You get what I'm saying? I don't want to be a medium. Like, I really don't. I don't got time for motherfuckers to be running around my crib, waking me up at night, trying to tell me how they died. I really don't. So I got some sage right here. I just opened my window. I'm sorry to interrupt y'all reading, but somebody was coming through, and I can't allow that. And I feel like if I don't nip it in the butt now, it's gonna get worse. But anyways, like I was saying, you make people feel like they are listened to. You make people feel like whatever they're saying is important and stuff like that. So therefore, people really like talking to you, really like being around you and stuff like that. They feel like they can be their complete self. And even if you don't agree, they don't feel judged. They feel like, okay, it's just a disagreement, but it's okay for me to feel that. Like, it's okay for me to feel that way, but this person still disagrees with me. So basically what I mean is you are like a safe space for people, and that's what makes you lit. You're a safe space for people to be themselves, and no, you're not a pushover, because a pushover would be somebody who feels like they have to agree to be a safe space. You don't feel like you have to be a great fit. You don't feel like you have to be an agreeance to be a safe space. You feel like you can just try to see it from other people's perspectives and acknowledge how they feel and respect how they feel, but still communicate how you feel and communicate something that may or may not be better, and at least in your eyes, okay? Then you have wait and see. So what also makes you lit is you being very patient. So I feel like you're very patient in life and very patient with people and very peaceful. People don't understand how you can sit and be so patient with things, especially when it's the things that you want in life or things that you want to do in life. Like, your friends, you like, some of you guys might be in college and all your friends are panicking about how you guys' life are going to turn out. Any negative spirits, any spirits at all, you're not welcome in here unless they're my angels or spiritual team. Please leave. But everyone else might be bugging out, like, how the fuck are we going to, like, live? Like, where are we going to live? Like, you know, what's graduation going to be like? How am I going to get a job? Where am I going to get a job? Etc. And you could just be like, man, the universe is going to bring me whatever the fuck it bring me, when it's time for me to bring me that. So I don't feel worried at all, because I know I'm going to have more than what I want. I know that I'm going to have more than what I need, more than what I want. I'm going to have everything that I need. Even if it's not as soon as I move out of college, even if it does take me maybe 2 or 1 year to really get what I want, I'm going to get what I want in patience. And then your friends are like, how can you sit there and just not be panicking? Because you really don't know. You don't know what's going to happen. You don't know when it's going to happen or anything like that, but yet you're calm. But I feel like for you, you're so connected to yourself, and you can see things from, and because you're able to see things from different perspectives, it's not hard for you. Like, for example, it's like you might look at it as, okay, I don't know if I'm gonna get a job straight out of a, if I'm gonna get the job that I went to school for right out of college, but I do know there's plenty of jobs available, and I know, like, while I'm looking for the job or applying to the job that I want, I can maybe take a year to explore other things that I might like, or, you know, I could learn things from the temporary job until I reach the job of my career or something like that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you just look at it from different perspectives, or at least I have money. You know what I'm saying? Like, at least I have some type of income, right? So you look at it from different perspectives. So that's really cool. Then you have the loyalty card. So what I'm saying with this loyalty card is, what makes you really lit is you are able to maintain relationships and friendships. I feel like you had, since because you are so under, oh, if you haven't already, some of you guys might be comedian or therapist. I know that's like different, but like, people see you as that. They see you as being really, really funny, and they see you as being some type of therapist, somebody they can talk to. So maybe you should look for a career in therapist. Maybe some of you guys are in school for psychology or therapy or what have you, right? But honestly, what I'm seeing here with this loyalty card, it's like you have long-standing relationships with people. You have a lot of long-standing relationships with people because they trust you. And they trust you like no other. You know what I'm saying? Because they feel like they trust your, they feel like you're, they feel like they trust your stuff, your morals and your, it's not mindset, it's something else. They trust your, I don't want to say judgment, because it's not judging. It's just like, I don't know, you are a safe space. Like, your whole aura, everything about you is a safe space for people, and they really like that, and that's what makes you lit. What makes you lit is the fact that you're always willing to give. You're really good at giving advice. I feel like some of you guys have been through a lot. A lot of people resonate with you. A lot of people connect with you. A lot of people, a lot of people, like, they feel like they see themselves in you, though. So I guess they're trying to say that you're relatable. Yeah, I guess they're trying to say that you're relatable. They feel like you're very much relatable. Yeah, they feel like you're relatable. That's sweet, though. I feel like people really, really, really like being around you. Like, really. I feel like you bring a sense of peace. A sense of peace. I see a loyal friend. I see a smart friend. I see a friend. I see a real friend. Like, you're gonna say a real friend, a real lover. Cause I don't feel like this is a fake person. I don't feel like you're the type of person to tell somebody some shit that they want to hear. Like, you are a real authentic person. I can tell you're a really, real, really authentic and wise person. And a lot of people see that. A lot of other people see that as well. And that's what makes you so lit. That's really beautiful, pile number one. So let's see what your advice is. It says, what lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters combined to what lies within us. Then you have great works are performed not by strength but by perseverance. So what makes you lit is I feel like a lot of you guys have been through a lot in your past or have had certain experiences in your past that may not have been favorable, but Spirit wants to remind you that they have made you who the person that you are. They have made you into the beautiful person that you are, and maybe you had to go through these things so you could give this advice, so you could be more grounded by around others that you are now. See, like, things happen for a reason, like, you get what I'm saying? So I feel like those people who have been through a lot when they were younger or in their past and stuff like that tend to be a lot wiser. And maybe you always felt like you don't understand why you had to grow up so fast or why certain things had to happen to you in your youth or your younger days or, like, you know, in your past. You're like, damn, why is this happening to me now? But when you really think back on it, like, think of it like this. Like, maybe you had your first heartbreak really, really young. Really, really young. And it, like, tore you apart. You were traumatized or whatever. Right? Now, as an adult, you understand how to handle your first heartbreak. You understand how to handle heartbreak. You understand how to handle, like, inappropriate stuff. You understand. You understand that type of shit, right? Versus people who never went through anything when they were younger. Who never went through those things when they were younger. Who are going through those things now. And they just happen to be around you. Now, you're able to give sound advice because you already been through it, even though you're a young soul. You get what I'm saying? Some of us are putting people's lives as healers, and I feel like people, a lot of people who watch tarot and in the spiritual community, most of us have some type of healing power, whether that be like an empath or like actual healing capabilities or whatever, what have you. Most of us have something more in us than the average person who is not awakened to their spirituality. So I feel like that's kind of what's going on here with you. So you had to persevere. You survived for a reason. You might have all, some of you guys maybe survived something really traumatic, like a car accident or something. I'm saying like a crash. Something really bad happened and you survived it. And you don't understand why you survived it. You survived it to be a, yeah, I'm hearing total, like total. You survived to be a beacon of light. You survived to be an angel. You survived to be a, what? A token of appreciation. What is the word? It's literally right there, Spirit. Come on, Spirit. Come on, come through. To be a mentor, to be what? To be an angel, to be a lot of things, to be an inspiration. That's the word I'm looking for. You survive to be an inspiration. That, my friend, is very beautiful. People view you as a genuine person. Like, even if they're not your friend, they view you as a genuine person. And I know that sometimes you may feel like your generosity and you being a good person is being taken advantage of. But at the same time, who are you really? Are you changing? Are you saying, oh, I don't want to be this genuine, nice person. I don't want to be this real person in a world full of everybody who's fake and they look like they're winning. Okay, but that's not who you really are. So who would you be lying to? Us or yourself? You would be lying to yourself. You get what I'm saying? You will be lying to yourself if you try to be like everyone else and not be genuine. Being genuine and honest and shit is what makes you lit, and that's what makes you you. So never give up on that, okay? Never give up on that. But with that being said, that is your reading, pile number one. I hope it resonates. If it does, please let me know. Make sure you like this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Hit the post notification bell so you can be notified every time I post a video. If you are interested in a personal reading, that information is in the description box below. If you're interested in my free reading giveaway, all you have to do is leave a red heart in the comment section below. And with that being said, I'm going to move on to pile number two. I do have a same day reading sale going on. I'm not sure when I'm going to end it, so if you're interested in that, the link is also in the description box below. You are allowed to ask two questions for $25.99. I will get your reading to you within 24 hours, okay? But with that being said, we're going to see what makes pile number two lit. Okay. I was confused a little bit. This seemed like random. I feel like a lot of random shit happens in your life. I feel like you a random ass person. This reading is kind of random. So I'm like looking at this, it's like, because it looks like here with the Fool card, it looks like you're walking away from something. Walking away with from people who have a cap on their life. This I'm not understanding, so I probably have to pull again for this. But, okay, this is a situation. It looks like you're walking away from people who have a cap on their life. Okay, so what's what makes you lit? This is very interesting. I feel like some of your guys maybe came from a neighborhood, a family, or a friend group that was just negative. Or if they wasn't negative, they don't really have... They don't really have a purpose. Like, everybody has a purpose, but the people, they not living. Like, they just here. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, they not main characters or nothing. Like, they're just here. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's, because you're not, like, I feel like everyone has a mission, but then, like, some people are literally just here to live their life, and, like, they don't have nothing extra they're supposed to be doing, right? I feel like you may have looked around one day and was like, fuck this, why am I here? Like, we not doing shit, you not doing shit. Like, this is not going to move me forward, right? And I feel like you were scared at first. You were scared because you barely wanted to do that. You barely wanted to do that. You felt trapped for a long time. You may have felt trapped around these people, around this lifestyle for a long time. For some of you guys, this could be a life of crime. This could be a life of crime. This could be a life of, like, I don't know. Some of you guys might do sex magic too, or you might do something tonight. I was thinking about it, and that's like a confirmation. But it's like something like that. Like, you were trained to something that was not what it seemed, and you knew that it wasn't what it seemed. Like a lifestyle or a friend group or something that just was not going anywhere, and you walked away from that. These people still miss you though. These people still miss you in this, the people from this lifestyle, whether it be just because they were like boring or like unmotivated or actually negative and criminals and shit like that, or just liars and or just something like that, or just people that didn't want to heal, they remember you. They always remember you. They always think about you. They always wish they could be like you because they feel like you made it out. They feel like you made it out of something, and they feel like they can't make it out, or they don't want to make it out, right? But they do, but they don't. Like, you get what I'm saying? So there's that. I feel like, okay. This shit is specific. Somebody came out. Somebody speaking today. Cause I'm like, this looked like a story. What story is this? Cause I'm just wondering why you lit. But I guess somebody specifically supposed to see this. But it looks like you tried to come back. So what makes you lit is I feel like you walked away from shit, or you walk away from shit that does not serve. Well, whoever this is, y'all walked away for some shit that was not moving. It was not moving you forward. It was not propelling you forward, whether it be friends, family, lifestyle, whatever. Right? Those people holding space for you because they want you to come back. They miss you. They want to be like you on the other side. So obviously you made it. You must have expanded your mind and was not scared to be different and stick out. And that's what, so you went ahead and you chose to do differently. The thing that makes you lit though, pile number two, is the fact that you came back. You came back and tried to give to your community or grab people from your past and bring them to where you are in life. So maybe you decided to get out of some type of life of crime, right? And then, oh, somebody decided to get married. Somebody probably was a whore. Decided to get married finally. But you decided to bring your... To try to bring your friends or your family or whoever out of the lifestyle they were in that you left to kind of propel them and show them it's more. When the thing that, but why does it make you lit is because a lot of people, they elevate and then they leave their past behind. Like, they don't try to go back and help their friends. They don't try to go back and help their family. They be like, fuck them. I got a better life. I don't even want nothing to do with you. You came back and tried to grip people out. And sometimes people do come with you. Sometimes people be like, okay, I want to do what Tommy's doing. I want to do what Sarah's doing. I want to do what Kayla's doing instead of being in this negativity. And sometimes you can get them out, right? And then sometimes they take a little longer to get out, so maybe you'll come back. The thing that makes you licked out is you keep fucking coming back. You never give up. You never give up on them. No matter how much people get on your fucking nerves and you like, yo, you really a lost fucking cause. You get on my nerves so bad. Like, you're really literally ruining your life. You're really going nowhere. You're pissing me off because I'm trying to help you. You still go back and put your energy and time in trying to help these people. So it's just like, that's what makes you lit. It's like you've been stabbing your back so many times. You've been cutting your back so many times. People have broken your heart so many times. And you stitch that shit back together. You stitch that shit back together and you continue to help. You continue to help, pile number two. You continue to help. Motherfuckers done broke your heart. Literally. It's like, damn, I'm trying to help you and you stole from me. Or damn, I'm trying to help you and you speaking negatively on me. But you still continue to help. No matter how much it penetrates your heart, that shit's still pumping. The main reason this is you know that with a little bit of tender love and care, everyone can be great. Some people just need a little help. With this book under the small witch, you know that this small witch could be a big witch one day. You know that this small witch could be a great witch one day. But right now, your little witch needs to learn this book of spells. This little witch needs more help. Some of you guys also might be in the witchcraft too. Some of you guys might have been in a cult. I don't know if you call it a cult. No, it's called a coven. I would never be a coven. I'm sorry. No shade, but like, covens is like, I don't like being told what to do. But maybe some of you guys were in a coven and the type of magic they were doing wasn't good. Or it was negligent in magic. Because you can do magic and want to do good magic, but you could be negligent. Like, you could be doing love spells and sex spells on motherfuckers, and you don't need to be doing that shit. You know what I'm saying? Do some money spells, do some self-healing spells. Just because you know how to do magic don't mean you should use magic for everything. It don't mean you should use magic on everyone. You really need to pick and choose when to use magic. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're going to use that on a person, that motherfucker better be trying to kill you. You get what I'm saying? That's how I feel about it anyway. If you're going to use magic, that motherfucker better be trying to kill you. Like, you can't be using magic because somebody fucking hurt your feelings. You get what I'm saying? That's when you use magic on yourself for healing, or that's when you ask your spirit guides to help you. You cannot. You know what I'm saying? I feel like that's maybe the people that you're around were doing that shit. I feel like I'm going to get a whole paragraph story. And you were like, yo, y'all don't have to use y'all magic for this. You can use magic to help you manifest and level up instead of putting hexes on people and love spells on niggas. Like, you get what I'm saying? It's so much more to us. It's so much more we can do. So why don't we do that? And I feel like that's where you went with it. And maybe, like, you're trying to teach them a different type of craft, or the craft that they were using, the craft they were using was borderline evil and didn't even know it because they probably wasn't even educated. Because some bitches do that too. I used to do that. I used to use witchcraft without even, like, reading about it. But now, like, I'm careful about what I do. But, I see that. But yeah, that's what makes you lit. It's like, but your energy is like a no person left behind type of energy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're like no person left behind. Let's see what your advice is. You have, I am not a has been, I am a will be. So your advice is, again, yes, you have gotten out of this, whatever the fuck this situation is. And they want you to know not to judge yourself. Don't think, because I feel like a lot of times when you move out of a space that was negative and you try to go back with negative people, they always try to act like you think they better than them. But it's like, you don't even be thinking that. You just like, maybe I just feel better and I want you to feel better too. So that's why I'm telling you this the way I'm telling you that. But sometimes negative people, you really can't tell them nothing. So they want you to know. And people try to bring up your past or stuff that you used to do, and you know that's not who you are anymore. You don't have to claim that energy. You don't have to claim that person. You're like, I don't even know that motherfucker. This is who I am now. I don't know who you're talking to or who you're referring about, but you're not talking about me because I don't know who that person is. I am, this is me, right? You simply have to put one foot in front of the other and keep going. Spirit wants you to continue your journey. Like, I don't feel like you're getting drawn back anyway. I don't see you going back at all. I feel like once you made your decision, you make your decision. But Spirit wants you to understand not to fall back victim. I know you want to be in the trenches and you want to help poor people out. I know you want to help your family. I know you got information that can help them, but also be careful to make sure that you're not disrupting your past. You get what I'm saying? Somebody is picking up their sister late at night from somewhere or somebody other female. It could be a cousin or sister from somewhere she's not supposed to be. And they specifically want me to warn you that you can get killed next time you pick her up from where you are or get hurt or something like that. It might not be killed, but it's something dangerous about where you're picking her up from and how you're picking her up and how late you're picking her up from. I think maybe she might be a drug addict or somewhere in like an abusive relationship or some shit. They just saying stop going there. They're saying stop going there. If anything, call her an Uber or something like that, or like let her know like I can't keep coming there at this time. I can't keep coming over every time your boyfriend fight. Like they're saying that's a situation she has to pull herself out of and let her come to you. Do not pick her up from that place anymore. So I don't know if it's a friend, a cousin, or a sister, but I feel like it feels like a sister energy. But sometimes a sister, a female, that if you a friend, you know how it is. Like you got a best friend around you a lot, it could feel like a sister and shit like that. So take heed to that message, because that's very important. Again, I'm literally seeing like a dusty ass neighborhood and somebody driving down there to get somebody, and the neighborhood just look, I don't know, you know what I'm saying? Just be careful, okay? But with that being said, that is your reading, pile number 2. I hope it resonates. If it does, please let me know. Make sure you like the video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Hit the post notification bell so you can be notified every time I post a video. If you're interested in entering my free reading giveaway, all you have to do is leave a red. I'm going to do my free reading giveaway too. I forgot. We hit 5K. So I'm going to be announcing that tomorrow morning. Okay? But if you're interested in getting a personal reading, information description below. I am offering same day readings, 2-question readings for $25.99. If you're interested in that, all you have to do is click the link in the description box and go ahead and make your purchase and email me 2 questions that you want answered, and I will send you your reading in within 24 hours. Okay, pile number 3. What makes you lit? From the bottom of the deck. What makes you lit? This is funny. This is funny. This is funny. Okay. So, what makes you lit is this. So, I feel like, okay, let me make sure though. This is funny though, because this is what makes you lit. Like, you're one of them people, pile number 3, that don't know how beautiful they are, they don't know how handsome they are, or something like that. Yeah. So I love tarot because it's like I'm a little fuzzy right now because I feel like that energy has threw me off a little bit, but I like to see that I'm still connected. But what I feel is this. I feel that this is a beautiful reading about somebody who doesn't know how much of a beauty that they truly are. They don't know how much of a beauty that they truly are. And that's what makes you lit. I feel like you're literally a unicorn, that you're different. You're probably really, really sexy, really, really hot, really, really pretty, really handsome, really good looking, really, really good looking. Like, I mean, like, and I don't mean like this regular, like, good looking, like by European standards or by like, you know, what people think is good looking, like on TV. I mean, like, you look like a fucking like unrealistic Disney princess or some shit. Like, you just look so beautiful, like, you know what I'm saying, or so handsome, like a Prince Charming or some shit. Like, you literally look like everyone's fantasy. Like, literally, like, when they fell in love, that's what the fuck people were seeing. When they see, like, on TV with a character on TV, that's what the hell they were seeing. Like, you look very, very beautiful, very whimsical. People feel like looking at you, their life would be easy and stuff like that. Like, I don't know. You're definitely burning hot. You attract a lot of attention. Wherever you go, you attract so much attention, but you're so mysterious at the same time. So it's like people, what makes you lit is you're very, very beautiful and very, very attractive. Like, you literally light up a room. However, people are very much scared to talk to you because, like, they're scared to talk to you. They don't know what to say. And they also feel like you look like somebody who would be like, fuck out of here. Like, if they come at you, like, a lot of people want to come at you. A lot of people want to talk to you, but they know not just anybody can go over there, right? Like, look at all these dragons. They all want to eat this man, but they don't. They a lot of them are not gonna. They don't know. Like they still backed up a little bit because they're like, yo, this motherfucker got a sword, so I can't just go over there and try to eat him or whatever, because this person is not having that. This person's a fighter. People, what makes you lit is that you're a pretty woman or a handsome man, but you're not easy. Like, you know what I'm saying? You're not somebody that's easy. You're not someone who's easily taken. You're not somebody who's easily fooled. You're not somebody that somebody can come in with some game. Like, and even if they are like a quote unquote good person, like they still have to be your type. So people know they have to be their whole selves and true selves before for them to even get next to you, for them to even talk to you, for them even to spark your interest. But even still, like, if you don't like them, you just don't like them, right? People feel like what makes you lit is the fact that you are whole. You are a whole person. Like, you are the type of person that enjoys your own company, that enjoys your own time, that enjoys your own space. Like, you're not needy. You don't need validation. I'm not gonna say you don't need people, because everyone needs people, but you're not somebody who needs people. We're gonna say that. You're not like, oh my God, I need a boyfriend, oh my God, I need a girlfriend, I need this, I need that. You're not that, right? Therefore, people put you on a pedestal, because your four cards over here to help me verify your images. You get what I'm saying? It's like everyone's in competition with you, but you're not even worried about people. Everyone's in competition with you, but you're not even worried about other people. That's why you go the length. Like, I'm trying to say, it's like if you're running a race, right? And you're focused on running, but the other person next to you is so focused on you and how fast you're going and what you're doing. Eventually, they're going to trip and fall, and then you're going to run right past them. So that's what it's like, that, right? So then people try, but yeah, so you have that with scorekeeping. It's like people be trying to compete with you, but you're not even trying to compete. So more, it makes you even more valuable and even more more wanting to be caught and stuff. And people put you on a pedestal because it's like, how is this person so unapologetically like fine and hot and shit like that? You know what I'm saying? And they just don't want to. And nobody can capture them. Like, you get what I'm saying? They're a whole person. They don't give a fuck what nobody think. Like, you get what I'm saying? They're content on their own. They can do everything on their own, and nobody can really lock them down because nobody's good enough. I'm not even good enough. I don't even know why I'm looking at this person, right? So you might have a lot of dating problems, and you think that you got dating problems because something wrong with you, and maybe you watch this because you're like, oh my God, what's wrong with me today? Like, you might feel insecure. There's nothing to feel insecure about, baby, because literally people are scared of you, and they feel like they're not good enough for you, right? You're not. The thing is also what makes you lit, and I honestly don't agree with this, but spirit is what it is. You don't use your dark femininity. You don't use your dark masculinity. You just be you, and you be bright, and you be beautiful. Because honestly, you could be getting a lot more with your looks and your personality. You could literally have the world. Like, if you talk to the nice, if you talk to the right people, you can literally get what you want. You can literally manifest what you want. But it's like, but makes you even lit. And I guess I wish I could say that too. I keep hearing hard dick makes opportunities, presents opportunities. I seen that in a show the other day. And I guess what that basically meant is that you can use your looks if you really wanted to get ahead in life. You could just use your looks. But what makes you even more lit is because you don't even depend on that, even though you could. Like, you literally could, but you don't. Like, you manifest and grow things, like, on your own. And you just do it so beautifully. And, like, people just watch you. And they're like, oh, my God, that person is so lit. People just watch, like, oh, my God, that person is so lit. That person is so beautiful. That person is so smart. That man is so handsome. And he doesn't use his looks to get a whole bunch of girls. She doesn't use her looks to do nothing. Like, people might do stuff for you, but I feel like you also the type of person that's like, that makes people like people have to beg you to do something for you. And spirit is saying, like, first of all, if somebody offered to do something for you, let they ass fucking do it. Second of all, some stuff, right? Unless you get a funny feeling, go ahead and let them do it. It's okay sometimes. But that's also what makes you lit about it, because it's not like you're trying to use people. Because some people know what they have and they try to use people, but you choose not to. And that's what makes you lit and very beautiful, pile number three. Right? I'm kind of jealous. I don't know. I used to be like that, though. I like using my dark femininity now. I don't know. It's fun. But you do what's best for you. Like, but You have, as far as your advice, you have great works are performed not by strength, but by perseverance. So Spirit wants you to know that you're going to get where you're going. It might take you longer. It might take you, you know, it might take you longer. It might be a little bit more obstacles because you don't want the help or because you, you know, you're so full and whole. You prefer to do everything alone, but you're still going to get there. It just might be a little bit harder. But if you want to like fast forward a little bit, you can try to use some of the resources. You don't have to, like, don't use them if you absolutely cannot deal with the person. But look, listen, if Spirit sends somebody in your life to help you, you better use that shit. But anyway, that is your reading, pile number 3. I hope it resonates. If it does, please let me know. Make sure you like this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Hit the post notification bell so you can be notified every time I post a video. If you are interested in getting a personal reading, that information in the description box below. If you are interested in entering my free reading giveaway, all you have to do is leave a red heart. I'll be choosing my next winner at 6,000 subscribers. And I will see you guys in my next reading. Bye.